What is ideal gas? Or is water vapor an ideal gas? And we know that TV diagram, and we know the compressed liquid region and vapor fluid mixture and superheated region. After that, this is the saturated line for water. This is the saturated line for gas. You know this. But in this situation, we have to look superheated region, because in superheated region, in all substances are gas phase. Therefore, we look to superheated region, therefore. And what is ideal gas? At pressures below 1 kilopascal in water, of course, in this situation we talk about the water. Water vapor can be treated as an ideal gas regardless to of its temperature within negligible error less than 1%. It means that in the at low pressures, here is the, as remember again, this is the TV diagram, temperature and specific volume diagram. This is the hill. We look like this curves look like a hill. And what is the incompressed liquid region after that here, after that here? And this is, for example, we draw two line. The first line is the upper line is the P2, the lower line is the P1. In the situation, P2 is greater than the P1, as you remember. In the situation, therefore, in low pressures, 0.8 kilopascal in 10 kilopascal, they said that at before the 10 kilopascal, it means all the gas or vapor are ideal gas, regardless its temperature. Also, if we don't look to temperature, and our pressure is the 10 below the 10 kilopascal, all the gas is treated, or the water vapor is treated as an ideal gas. Also, in high pressure, at high pressure, however, the ideal gas assumption yields unacceptable errors. Therefore, in high pressure, water vapor cannot treat it as an ideal gas. Also, in this situation, there are so and there are gives a lot of errors, not like small errors like this one. It gives much bigger than error the one. Also, in the critical region, you know that this is the critical point. For this critical region, vapor or the another substances cannot treat it as an ideal gas, because particularly in the vicinity of the critical points and the saturated vapor line. Okay, I mean that in this region, the vicinity of the region, the water vapor cannot be treated as an ideal gas. Also, you can ask something, or also, I'm going to ask one question. In air conditioning applications, the water vapor in the air can be treated as an ideal gas. Why? In air conditioning applications, for example, we have house or we have hotel or something like that. And in this situation, we have air conditioning or in Turkish klima applications. And in this situation, water can be treated as an ideal gas. Why? Because in this situation, the pressure of the water or pressure of the water vapor or air, pressure of the water vapor in the air is so below, also below the 10 kilopascal. That's why it's treated as an ideal gas. But in steam power plant application, the pressure involved are usually very high. Therefore, ideal gas relations should not be used. I mean that we look to pressure, and one of your friends said that low pressure and high temperature give us the ideal gas state to us. Okay. give us the ideal gas relations. And we can use the ideal gas relations with high temperature and low pressure. It means low density. Again, here, the gases behave an ideal gas at low densities, low pressures, and high temperature. Okay, the gases, water vapor or the other gases, behave as an ideal gas at low densities and high pressures. Okay. And what is the compressibility factor of Z? A factor that accounts for a deviation of a real gases from ideal gas behave at a given temperature and pressure. And it means that at a given temperature or pressure, if the real gas is equal to ideal gas or is it deviates from the real gas. Okay, it deviates from real gas from the it deviation of the real gas of from ideal gas. I mean that in Turkish maybe I can explain better. Burada verilen sıcaklık ve basınç da gerçek gazın ideal gazdan ne kadar ayırdığını, ne kadar ayrıştığını bize gösteren bir faktör. The factor is the Z, PV. This is the normal one is like this, as you remember, PV, RT. But in this situation, the Z is including in the equation of state. In the equation, therefore, this is the Z, is the compressible factor. If the Z one is the gas is the ideal gas, but if the Z is bigger than one or Z is smaller than one, is the real gas. This is the this is the wrong writing here. If Z is smaller than one or greater than one, this is the real gas. It means that Z is equal to one. Is the real gases. Also, one question and the answer is here. Also in the Turkish translation is also here. But what exactly constitutes low pressure or high temperature? Düşük ve basın sıcaklıklarda belirtilmek istenen sıcaklık, yani sınırlar nedir? Ya da biz düşük veya düşük basınç yüksek sıcaklıklarla ne anlatmak istiyoruz? The answer, the temperature of the pressure of a substance is high or low relative is critical temperature of pressures. Cevabını Türkçe verelim, daha sonra grafikte açıklayalım. Bir maddenin sıcaklığını ve basıncını yüksek veya düşük diyebilmek için kritik sıcaklığı ve basıncını göz önüne almak gerekir diyor. Buna daha sonradan geleceğiz. Next slide, we will talk detail of it. After that, they said that at very low pressures, its pressures goes zero, all gases approach ideal gas behavior regardless their temperature. Also, they said that here, at pressure of below 10 kilopascal, water vapor can treat it as an ideal gas regardless or irrespective of its temperature. Okay, in the situations, the same is the pressure goes zero. All the gas is behave like an ideal gas, and it is the ideal gas behavior is done or is made regardless of their temperature. Okay. Now again the English question and the Turkish translation is here. They said that what exactly constitutes low pressure? Because in low pressure and high temperature, we said that the gas is behaving like an ideal gas. And you look to, you know the two diagram, two basic diagram, TV diagram or PV diagram here. In TV diagram, this is the hill, it's compressed liquid mixture region, superheated region, as you see, compressed liquid. Superheated mixture region, and this is the saturation line of fillet, saturation of the gas. And this is the P1 and P2 in this temperature and specific volume graphics. Pressure is constant here. And you looked at, this is the, for example, this is the low temperature or high temperature. in the situation, because or this is the for example, this is the high temperature, because this temperature is bigger than the critical point. That's why they say that this is the high temperature. Again, we look at the PV diagram. This is the high pressure or low pressure. And if you look to this one, this is the low pressure, of course. This is the this pressure is smaller than the critical point. That's why we set the low pressure. Therefore, we set that this is the low pressure is smaller than the critical point pressure. This is the high temperature. This is the greater than the critical temperature. Okay, critical point temperature. Therefore, we look to if we know the critical point temperature or pressure, therefore we define that this is the low temperature and that this is the low pressure and the high temperature. Okay. Now, the other equation of states, we have several equations. Also, several equations have been proposed to some researchers or some scientific men. And the Van der Waals equation, Berhalet equation, or Beatty-Bridgman equation, or something like that, or Wirral equation. Okay, we look to, we don't enter, or I do not explain detail of this, because but in Van der Waals equation of state is found in 1873 with Van der Waals, by Van der Waals. Van der Waals is a scientific man who comes from Holland, Netherlands. And in this situation, this is the two constant A and B. This is similar like this. This is also similar, P, B. This is the small one, of course, because in the big one, we can write M here. Pardon, not RT, specific volume. In pressure, it gives the one constant enters here, and in specific volume, one constant is entering here. For A, A is related to intermolecular attraction force. The A is determined with the intermolecular attraction force. And the B is the specific volume. B is the volume occupied by the molecules themselves. And this is changing with, of course, temperature critic or pressure critic values or something like it's calculated with temperature critic and pressure critic. And in the occurrence of the Van der Waals equation state is often inadequate. Therefore, we cannot use this equation, because sometimes they're said that is often, not sometimes, is often is much bigger than the sometimes. Often is cyclical, sometimes is bazen, as you know that. Often is inadequate. Also, this curves, also this Van der Waals equation of state is construct like this. First derivation of pressure divided by first derivation of pressure, and derivation is made from a specific volume. First derivation of the pressure at t critical constant is zero, and the second pressure, second derivation of the pressure with specific volume, again the T is equal to T constant, T critical constant is zero. Therefore, the ideal gas Van der Waals equations curve is like this. But in the situation, as you remember, in the critical point, vicinity of the critical point, all the gas substances of the gas cannot behave like an ideal gas. Therefore, this formulation is not suitable for us. Okay, they said that the equation of state is often inadequate. And other, we looked to other equation of states, gas, ideal gas of equation of states. This is the Beat and Bridgman equation of states. It founds 1928. I cannot explain detail and this is the formulation of this. Benedikant ve Probyn equation is like this. But this is the real equation of state. It looks like a series because you know the Taylor series or the other series. In the series, they like right here. The series like this. RTV divided by AT we can say like this. And 80 point n. This is the n is started 0 to infinite. Okay. But A is changing AT, DT or something like that. In this situation, the AT, B, A, the coefficient A, B, C, and T. Also the A, B, and C, and T is function of the T, as you know that. As you see that, of course. And the coefficient A, T, B, T, and C, T, and so on, E, T, or something like that. The function of temperature are called virial coefficients. And these coefficients gets from experimental results and gets from the statistical mechanics. Okay, determine the from experiments and the statistical mechanics. But in our lesson, of course, we use this one. We use this one. So much after that, we can use the other type of the ideal gas. Okay. Now we finished our lesson now, but this chapter, of course. Now, this is the example you can solve this. This is, for example, water. This is up to you, and this is the question, and this is the answer given to the next slide. For example, this is water, and pressure is given, temperature is given, and this is the what is the phase situation. This is the superheated water or compressed liquid water or whatever, and you define the enthalpy of this. And if this is fluid vapor mixture, you can write in the quality of this again. This is, for example, R130A fluid or substances, and this is the temperature zero, H is 100, and what about the pressure, and what about the phase, and what about the originality? Okay, you can look in the table, and if you have a question, also if you do not calculate this next lesson, you can ask me. Okay, this is also the same. This is the question, this is answer. Also, this is also question, and this is answer. Okay. And this is up to you. Okay, you can solve this one. Now we can pass the other chapter. I didn't send this one, this chapter now. I sent this chapter. First of all, I make a PDF. Also, you know that our examination, I think, will be at 27th of November, I think, as far as I know. You know that?
Yes, sir.
This one is true, huh? 27th of the November. Am I true or not? As far as I remember, on Sunday. Now we pass the thermodynamic first law, detail first of all in chapter 4. We will look in detail closed system. After that, we will look in detail open system thermodynamic first law. After that, we make midterm exam. After that, we pass the thermodynamic second law after the midterm exam. Okay, energy system now. This is my YouTube channel. And I have 175 followers. Yeah. Now, Axis Istanbul C. And our university is, our name of university is so strange. University, Istanbul University, Cerrahpaşa. This name does not obey the aslında bu isim tamlamasına bile uymuyor yani. İstanbul Cerrahpaşa Üniversitesi denilebilirdi. İstanbul Üniversitesi Cerrahpaşa ne ya? Now document, new document. Document. Thermodynamics chapter 4. Okay, this is not related with other equation of state or something like that, but chapter 4. Chapter 4. Okay. And please check you if you get that this document or not. Okay. First, you check this document is come via Axis or not. You get one or not? Okay. Now I start the chapter 4. Energy analysis of closed systems. I mean the thermodynamic first law of closed system. First of all, I ask, what is closed system?
Hocam, madde giriş çıkışının olmadığı fakat enerji giriş çıkışının olduğu sistemlerdir.
Okay, it's true, but in Turkish. Okay. Sometimes I explain in Turkish, so it's not a problem, but yeah, if you explain in English, you can explain in English, okay? And what about the R contents of the energy analysis of closed systems? First, we look the moving boundary work. Okay, it's so critical work, moving boundary work. After that, we look the polytropic process. After that, we look the energy balance for closed system, thermodynamic first law, and we look the specific heats. After that, we look the internal energy and type and specificity of the ideal gases. And now, lastly, internal energy, enthalpy and specificity of solid and liquids we looked at. Okay, for energy analysis of closed systems. Again, the objective is similar to our contents. And our aim is to examine the moving boundary work, PDV. And we looked at what is PDV. Work commonly incurred in the device such as automotive engines and compressors. And after that, we look to identify the first law of thermodynamics as simply as statement of the conservation of the energy of principle for closed systems. It means fixed mass, as you said that in closed systems. Mass is not changing, fixed mass, but energy is transferring its boundaries. Okay, this is the closed system. And develop the general energy balance applied to closed systems. Define the specific heat at a constant of volume and define the specific heat at a constant of pressure because specific heat changing with C with specific volume of constant volume and specific of constant pressure. Constant pressure and related the specific heat to calculation of the changes of internal energy and enthalpy of ideal gases. This is so important that this is related with the moving boundaries. and describe the incompressible substances and determine the changes in their internal energy and enthalpy. And we looked at what is incompressible. And solve energy balance problems for closed fixed mass and systems that involve the heat and work interaction for general poor substances and ideal gas and the incompressible substances. Okay. This is really good and this is so basic chapter. Now, what is the boundary work? Boundary work is, as said, that it used generally encounter or generally used in automotive engines or compressors. In compressors, there is piston cylinder device. Okay, this is the piston and this is the cylinder. Maybe you know the internal combustion engine, you know that maybe you're familiar in the commercial brakes, for example, Shell or the other gases, they said that if you use this gas, your engine is protected with the friction. But at the same time, it shows the piston and cylinder working. And you know, in the piston and cylinder working, this is the piston come here. Also in combustion engines, maybe you know that. This is the piston. This is the connection with the piston and the crankshaft. And the crankshaft is rotating and piston is moving linearly in the cylinder. Okay. This where they said that the piston and the cylinder applications is used or is encountered in automotive or compressors. Okay. Therefore, moving boundary, and we look to moving boundary work, PDV, they said that. First of all, the expansion and compression work in a piston cylinder device. Expansion is volume is increasing, compression is the volume is decreasing. Okay, here. And they said that what is boundary work? W, boundary, if this, they said that work is first Fs, okay. This is the F, this is the with small changings, but I write the general formulation. And F is, because pressure is the F divided by area, therefore F is PA multiple S, therefore W is pressure. And if we multiply area and the one direction, we get the volume. Okay. Therefore, firstly, you know that work, cylinder work is, boundary work is pressure multiple volume. Okay. Now, we look to this figure and we look to formulation. This figure, this is the expansion here. And this is the first state. And if we move the boundaries to up or upper with force, and this is the A is the cylindrical surface. It means P D squared divided by 4. Okay. If it is circular area. And this is the DC. The DC is the length of the expansion. And they said that boundary work is F multiple DS. And F is equal to pressure multiple area and multiple DS expansion of the length of the expansion. After that, we calculate the work, boundary work is PDA. And this is the, we use the delta, Kronecker delta. Why we use the Kronecker delta here? In Turkish and English, please explain.
Hocam, tek katlı integral olduğu için normal diferansiyel kullanılıyor olabilir mi?
Kronecker delta is used for path, because this moving boundary used this path ds, therefore moving boundary work is like delta Kronecker delta on wb is equal to fdc, therefore we can set that p dy, the volume, okay, the small volume changing. And in this situation, moving boundary is related with the path. This is because path function. Okay, therefore we use Kronecker delta. After that, if we integrate of this from one state to two states, we get the moving boundary work. Therefore, P dV, and this is the unit of this kilojoule, because you said that F is kilojoule, Newton multiple meter is the kilojoule. This one, this is also kilojoule, because we write that Newton divided by and meter cubic. It means Newton meter is also joule or kilojoule. Okay. Again, they said that the work is associated with the moving boundary work is called boundary work. Okay, because if the boundary work is exists, therefore boundary is moving. Therefore, we said that we say the boundary work instead of the moving boundary work. Okay. And quasi-equilibrium state, maybe you remember that, a process during which the system remains nearly in equilibrium in all times. It means that if we move this boundary so slow, therefore the pressure is not changing so much, therefore the the pressure of the other system or the other properties is not changing with times, therefore we said that this is the quasi-equilibrium process. Okay, also WB is positive for expansion, WB is the negative work, yeah, boundary work is positive is for expansion, and boundary work is negative for compression. In this situation we make positive, but if the forces exert the bottom of this from the top to bottom, this one, this is the compression, therefore boundary work is negative. Okay, now we looked at this figure, the first figure, the left one, and this is the PV diagram. This is the process path. Therefore, we use the Kronecker delta again. This is the path function, and this is the from state one to state two. Okay, therefore this is the expansion, and the boundary work is the positive. Therefore, we said that the dA is P, the area of this curve, under area of this curve is dA, but dA is not this A is not this A, okay? This is the cylindrical area, but this A is the under the curves area, okay? Under this curves area. The PA is equal to PDV. Therefore, for this situation, the work is calculated PDV, but if you calculate the whole work from state one to state two, therefore, I mean that for this one, if you calculate the whole area under this curve, we get the boundary work again here, okay? Also, if you calculate the area of under this curve, and we get the boundary work. Okay, anladınız mı? Bunu Türkçe açıkladım çünkü çok önemli. Bu alanın altındaki, bu çizginin altındaki alanı hesapladığımız zaman boundary work'i hesaplamış oluruz, tamam? Bunu da integralle hesaplamış olacağız o haliyle. Burada görüyorsun area diyor. Area is equal to A, and this A is, dA is calculated from the integral from 1 to 2, and this one is the from one to two PDV. This is the, of course, boundary work. Okay. And we look to here, this curve. This curve, they said that the from first state to second state, the path is come from A. This is the from the base, the from A path, from path of A, path of B, and path of C. You see that. But under the area under the this curve, again, the F, we look the boundary work is greater than the boundary work B, is greater than the boundary work C, because here the area of under the line A is bigger than the under the line area of under the line B is bigger than the, again, under the line, under the area, the area under the line C is the smallest one. Okay. Therefore, for example, boundary work of A, 10 kilojoule, boundary work can be 8 kilojoule, boundary work can C, 5 kilojoule. And the last one, if we have a cycle, because first of all, from zero to from one state to two state, after that from two state to first state, and this is the VNet is calculated like this. Again, maybe I'm going to define like this PV diagram. After that, from one to two. Okay. Therefore, this one. And from this one. One.
Hocam bir dakikadan az kaldı ya.
Biliyorum, biliyorum. Bunu açıklayıp bitireceğim zaten. This one and this is the area of this. This one I am going to write this. After that, this is this area is the net boundary work of this. Okay, next tomorrow I am going to explain again this one because this is so important issue. Okay. Next year, see you on tomorrow. Okay.
İyi günler hocam.
Okay, bye bye.